pero joder. Gabriel, there you are. So sorry, Ace, but Gabriel's taking some scrappy snacks. I tried to stop him, but he insisted. He said he wanted to learn more about the killer's psyche. Anyway, I'll take him back to the lab now. I have an antidote that'll get him back to normal. Call him Gabriel. Ace thought Gabriel has more sense than to take drugs, but I guess for him it was all in the name of science. In any case, our time is running out to solve this murder, so we better get cracking. We can see if we take another look around the record store. Come on, Ace, we gotta nab this killer fast. Let's see what we can find. Ace, this container's been labeled DJ Box of Shame. Doesn't sound very positive, does it? You better open the box in case there's anything related to our victim in it. If you think fixing that broken record is important, I'm with you. Let's do this, Ace. We got nothing to lose. Oh, we got no time to lose, is probably what he said. Divine in the back. You guys are right. Ace, this is a vinyl record. It was made by a duo called Teddy and Kahlua. Well, that's our victim's name. Could that be Teddy Brooks, the musician we met earlier? Very curious if Teddy made an album with our victim, seeing as he told us he despised her music. We have quite a few questions for the haughty musician. Yeah, what's your deal, man? VHS tapes, wow. Ace, this is DJ Box of Shame filled with VHS cassettes. I can't remember the last time I saw one of those. But yes, more importantly, one of them is labeled DJ Kaboom. This has to be about a victim. Let's get the tape straight away to Kathy and see what's so shameful on it. Hopefully, she'll still have an old school video player where she can watch it on. Hey, all I'm saying in the chat is I timed out Shield. And all of a sudden Mubot's okay with, oh no, Caps, he'll still be get you, he'll still get you. Mr. Brooks, we thought you hated Kahlua Kaboom's music, so imagine our surprise when we found the album you made with her. Oh drat, I can't believe copies of the blasted LP still exist. If you must know Secret Agent Ace, yes, Kahlua and I were once in a band together. We were doing really well, rather. Until the day Kahlua decided to go solo, that selfish cow left me high and dry without a care in the world. And while Kahlua went out to achieve great success and an adoring fan base, I can't get a gig for the love of money. I even lowered myself as far as to promote myself on an Instacam with Camroid 260 photographs, but it didn't work. The only thing that keeps me sane is a hit of scrappy snacks now and then again, and I may not be able to afford those soon. Well, Mr. Brooks, if we find out that you're resorting to murdering Miss Kaboom in revenge for her leaving you, then you'll be the one going solo to jail. Kathy, we sent you that VHS because we found it in a box labeled DJ Box of Shame. Did it have anything incriminating to say about her victim? I did have to dig for hours around my dad's cobweb attic to find his old video player, but it was worth it in the end. Take a look for yourself. All right, dude. Today I'm interviewing DJ Kalua Kaboom. Kalua, let's talk about your tunes, man. My music is my passion, dude. Standing over my turntable, seeing all those beautiful party people below me dancing and going ecstatic over my melodies, nothing compares. Yes. Well, Kalua, I just have one question for you. How can you live with yourself doing what you do? Whoa. Hang on, Kathy, is that? Yeah, even though the interview is recent, the rest of the recording has been obliterated by mold because Ziggy reused an old cassette. What was clear from what I could salvage is that your suspect Ziggy Sparks was furious with the victim, for what I don't know. Well, there's only one way to find out, isn't there, Ace? Let's have another word with Ziggy. You're banned for 10 minutes, Shield, because you were using all caps. I just thought it'd be funny. Hey, Secret Agent Ace, want to buy off my waffle pop? Robin, one of my awesomest customers, gave it to me. We'll pass, Mr. Sparks. We've watched your interview with Kalua Kaboom. What made you get so angry with her? Aw, man, why'd you have to go and watch that? To be honest, dude, I couldn't help myself. Kalua was desecrating the classics, man. Say what? She was remixing legendary songs from the greats with her uncool electronic beats. It was sacrilegious. Bowie wasn't made to be turned into dubstep remixes. Kalua used to be a chilled babe, but not anymore. She started going on crazy rants about everything from hating cheese to how video games will be the death of us. If only she indulged in some scrappy snacks. She'd have understood that the only things that matter are peace and love, man. Killer. Bad guy. Bad guy. She could be too. It's one or the other. Ace, for a chilled guy, Ziggy seems to be harboring a lot of anger towards the victim. What was all that about Kalua Kaboom hating cheese? I thought she was the face of Remia, Tulua's first cheese stall. I wonder what Tulua thought about Kalua's diatribes against the very thing she'd been paid to promote. Let's ask her. I definitely don't think it's her. Secret Agent Ace, I have a question for you. What kind of music does cheese listen to? R&B. Wow. That's a good one. But funny you mention music, because we've heard the DJ who used as the face of your brand had been bad-mouthing cheese. You can't have been happy about that. Ah, heck. Alright, I shan't deny it. I was absolutely furious. I was paid that lots of good money to be the face of my cheese and spent my precious time taking photos of her on my Camera 260. Everything was fine for a while, but then Kalua decided to become a vegan and started telling all her fans that cheese was the devil's work. I trusted her with my precious cheese, and she spat into my soul. How could she do that to me? Well, we trust that you didn't murder Miss Kaboom over a bit of cheddar. Nah. Well, Ace, this place is as clear as a pot of fondue. It now transpires that Kalua Kaboom had almost as many enemies as she did fans. She managed to infuriate the perennial calm Ziggy Sparks by desecrating classic songs. Was this enough for him to commit murder? Then there's Teddy Brooks, who was seriously jealous of Kaboom's success. And Tulua's Strophier, who was the victim annoyed by bad-mouthing the very cheese she was supposed to be sponsoring. But while the list of suspects remains wide, our time is short, so we better get on with our investigation. You're right. We know the killer went to the Waterside Market, and it's the perfect place to get rid of Evans. Let's make another sweep of it. Oh, man. So, S.H.I.E.L.D. is now... Alright, I'll mod you later. I'll do it after this chapter. Our camera that cropped up in our case. Last photo is still visible in the digital display on the back. And wait a second, that's a victim of our dead victim. Picture of our dead victim. This must be the camera the killer used to snap the photo we found earlier. Scrapping off that yellowy mush on the camera will be sure to provide a lead. Something incriminating could be hiding inside this discarded shopping bag. I agree. Let's take a look inside as fast as we can. Polish remover. let's get this yellow goo from the killer's camera straight to the lab. Shotgun bag. Could this be the gun the killer used to electrocute the victim to death? Rita will know. Let's get the weapon to her stat. Blue nailish and bow tie? Alright. Oh, man, I'm getting close to not having any cash. Hey, so now your time is tight, so I'll get straight to the point. I'm in no doubt that the electroshock gun you found was used to kill your victim. Excellent. How do you know? Well, first, it's a powerful weapon capable of releasing a strong enough charge to trigger cardiac arrest. Secondly, I checked with the lab rats, and your victim's DNA was on the gun, so there's no doubt she was zapped with this very electroshocker. And did this deadly electroshock gun reveal anything about our killer? Yes, Rupert found out the tiny blue flakes deposited on the gun. Upon closer inspection, they turned out to be nail polish. Looks like your killer chipped their varnished nails while committing their murderous deed. Well, Ace, our killer's nails won't stay very polished when they're scratching to get out of their prison cell. So the question then becomes, is it Zicky or is it the girl? Ace, I'll leave fashion conscious Amir to tell you about the yellow substance you collected from the killer's cameroid. Right you are, Roops. Ace, the sweet smelling gloop was beeswax. Beeswax? Polished wood? What does that have to do with fashion? This particular composition of beeswax is used to buff up a wooden bow tie. Wooden bow tie? What's next? Grass waistcoats? Pants made of clay? Well, it sounds ludicrous, I agree, but Amir assures me that they're very much a la mode these days. They definitely are. We can confirm the Akil's outfit will be adorned with a wooden bow tie. Well, Ace, we're closing in on our wooden bow tie wearing killer. They won't be getting away from us now. It's gotta be Ziggy. Ace, we got all the evidence we need to put Kaboom's killer under arrest. Let's go get him. Yep, nice call on the bow tie. And is she wearing a bow tie? She's not. Oh my goodness. Is it him? No, it can't be him. Wait, who's wearing the wooden bow tie? Oh, she is. Oh, snap. Interesting. Robin Ash, you're under arrest for the murder of Kalua Kaboom. Oh my gosh, why'd you need to throw any shade on me like that? I did nothing wrong. Maybe you should think about kicking your drug habit because we found your scrappy snacks all over the necklace you ripped off of DJ Kaboom. And maybe you'd be less salty if you took some scrappy snacks yourself? Yeah, but what about the electroshock gun you used to electrocute the victim, which we found covered in your nail polish? Are you totes kidding me? Like I'm the only person in the greens with painted nails? Enough of your lip, Miss Ash. We found the photo you took of your murderous handiwork and the camera you used. Your game is up, so confess. Why did you kill Kalua Kaboom? I killed her for revenge. Why else? Remember when I told you Kaboom gave one of my squad a seizure? Well, it wasn't just anyone. It was my sister. My little sister suffered from epilepsy, and the flashing lights were no-no for her brain. I told Kalua this, and she promised not to use strobe lighting. But she lied, and the crazy lights and techno beats were too much for my poor fragile hyper. She died from the seizure. What? DJ Kaboom's music show killed your sister? Yes, but it was ruled an accident. I didn't have the dollar to go after a powerful lawyer squad, so Kalua got away with it. Wow. So you decided to murder her instead. I had no choice. The rage was eating me alive, so I planned my attack. I knew Kalua would be on her own rehearsing in the morning, so I snuck into the blue flamingo, grabbed the sun gun, and attacked her from behind. I totally thought taking a photo of her would be satisfying proof of my revenge, but it just made me feel worse. Nothing will bring my sister back. Nothing. Miss Ash, this is indeed a troubling situation, but we have no choice to put you under arrest. Miss Ash, how do you plead in the murder of Kalua Kaboom? Whatevs, you already know I'm guilty. Look, I did it to avenge my sister, an eye for all that. Well, it is truly unfortunate that you had to lose your sister, but taking justice in your own hands is not the answer. Robin Ash, this court sentences you to 7 years in prison. Well, that's savage. You'll be out at 28, you'll be fine. Ace, Robin Ash's case was pretty tragic, and the emotions will, of course, run high when a loved one comes to harm, but that doesn't mean you can resort to murder. Look at me. I didn't go on a killing spree when my girlfriend went missing and returned with amnesia. That said, I still want to punch Marconi's smug little face. He's the only one Zoe remembers, so he has to be linked to her disappearance, but he won't talk. Ace, I think it's time to head back to Marconi's nightclub and dig up the truth on him once and for all. Let's do it. Let's do it. Guys, that is the end of chapter 3. It's been Pachinius 88. Over and out.